Book 17 of Confucian Analects by Confucius, translated by James Legge. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Yang Huo Di Shi Qi. Book 17. Yang Huo. Di Yi Zhang. Yang Huo Yu Jian Kong Zi. Kong Zi Bu Jian. Kui Kong Zi Tun. Kong Zi Shi Qi Wu Ye. Er Wang Bai Zhi. Yu Zhu Tu. Wei Kong Zi Yue. Lai, Yu Yu Er Yan. Yue. Huai Qi Bao Er Mi Qi Bang. Ke Wei Ren Hu. Yue. Bu Ke. Hao Cong Shi Er Qi Shi Shi. Ke Wei Zhi Hu. Yue. Bu Ke. Ri Yue Shi Yi. Sui Bu O Yu. Kong Zi Yue. Nuo. Wu Jiang Shi Yi. Chapter 1. Yang Huo wished to see Confucius, but Confucius would not go to see him. On this, he sent a present of a pig to Confucius, who, having chosen a time when Huo was not at home, went to pay his respects for the gift. He met him, however, on the way. Huo said to Confucius, "Come, let me speak with you." He then asked, "Can he be called benevolent who keeps his jewel in his bosom and leaves his country to Confucian?" Confucius replied, "No." "Can he be called wise who is anxious to be engaged in public employment and yet is constantly losing the opportunity of being so?" Confucius again said, "No." "The days and months are passing away, the years do not wait for us." Confucius said, "Right, I will go into office." 第二章. 子曰, 信相近也, 习相远也. Chapter 2. The Master said, "By nature, men are nearly alike. By practice, they get to be wide apart." 第三章. 子曰, 为上智与下愚不移. Chapter 3. The Master said, "There are only the wise of the highest class and the stupid of the lowest class who cannot be changed." 第四章. 子之五臣,闻弦歌之声. 夫子莞尔而笑曰,歌姬焉用牛刀? 子游对曰,昔者言也,闻诸夫子曰,君子学道则爱人,小人学道则易时也. 子曰,二三子,言之言是也。 前言细之耳. Chapter 4. The Master, having come to Wuchen, heard there the sound of stringed instruments and singing. Well pleased and smiling, he said, "Why use an ox knife to kill a fowl?" Zi You replied, "Formerly, Master, I heard you say, 'When the man of a high station is well instructed, he loves men. When the man of low station is well instructed, he is easily ruled.'" The Master said, "My disciples, Yan's words are right. What I said was only in sport."
第五章. 公山佛扰以必叛, 招子欲往. 子路不悦, 曰, 莫之也已, 何必公山世之之也? 子曰, 夫招我者而其徒哉? 如有用我者, 吾其为东周乎?
Chapter 5. Gongshan Fo Rao, when he was holding Pi, and in an attitude of rebellion, invited the Master to visit him, who was rather inclined to go. Zilu was displeased and said, "Indeed, you cannot go. Why must you think of going to see Gongshan?" The Master said, "Can it be without some reason that he has invited me? If anyone employ me, may I not make an Eastern Zhou?"
第六章. 子张问仁于孔子, 孔子曰, 能行无者于天下为仁矣, 请问之, 曰, 公, 宽, 信, 敏, 惠, 公则不武, 宽则得众, 信则人任言, 敏则有功, 惠则足以使人.
Chapter 6. Zizhang asked Confucius about perfect virtue. Confucius said, "To be able to practice five things everywhere under heaven constitutes perfect virtue." He begged to ask what they were, and was told, "Gravity, generosity of soul, sincerity, earnestness, and kindness. If you are grave, you will not be treated with disrespect. If you are generous, you will win all. If you are sincere, people will repose trust in you. If you are earnest, you will accomplish much. If you are kind, this will enable you to employ the services of others.
第七章, 必西招, 子欲往。 子路曰, 昔者有也, 文诸夫子曰, 轻于其身, 为不善者, 君子不入也。 必西以忠谋判, 子之往也, 如之何? 子曰, 然, 有是言也。 不曰坚乎, 磨而不灵, 不曰白乎, 蹑而不滋。 吾其刨瓜也在, 焉能济而不食?
Chapter 7. Bixi invited him to visit him. The master was inclined to go. Zilu said, "Master, formerly I have heard you say, when a man in his own person is guilty of doing evil, a superior man will not associate with him. Bixi is in rebellion, holding possession of Zhong Mou. If you go to him, what shall be said?" The master said, "Yes, I did use these words. But is it not said that, if a thing be really hard, it may be ground without being made thing? Is it not said that, if a thing be really white, it may be steeped in a dark fluid without being made black? I am a bitter gourd. How can I be hung up out of the way of being eaten?"
第八章, 子曰,有也,汝闻六言六必一乎? 对曰,未也,居无欲汝。 好人不好学,其必也愚,好智不好学,其必也当,好性不好学,其必也贼,好直不好学,其必也狡,好勇不好学,其必也乱,好刚不好学,其必也狂.
Chapter 8. The master said, "You, have you heard the six words to which are attached the six becloudings?" You replied, "I have not. Sit down, and I will tell them to you. There is the love of being benevolent without the love of learning. The beclouding here leads to a foolish simplicity. There is the love of knowing without the love of learning. The beclouding here leads to dissipation of mind. There is the love of being sincere without the love of learning. The beclouding here leads to an injurious disregard of consequences. There is the love of straightforwardness without the love of learning. The beclouding here leads to rudeness. There is the love of boldness without the love of learning. The beclouding here leads to insubordination. There is the love of firmness without the love of learning. The beclouding here leads to extravagant conduct."
第九章, 子曰,小子,何莫学夫诗? 诗可以兴,可以观。 可以群,可以怨,而知是父,远知是君,多至于鸟兽草木之名.
Chapter 9. The master said, "My children, why do you not study the book of poetry? The odes serve to stimulate the mind. They may be used for purposes of self-contemplation. They teach the art of sociability. They show how to regulate feelings of resentment. From them you learn the more immediate duty of serving one's father and the remoter one of serving one's prince. From them we become largely acquainted with the names of birds, beasts, and plants."
第十章, 子谓伯鱼曰,汝谓周南昭南一乎? 人而不为周南昭南,其犹正强面而立也与?
Chapter 10. The master said to Bo Yu, "Do you give yourself to the Zhonan and the Zhaonan? The man who has not studied the Zhonan and the Zhaonan is like one who stands with his face right against a wall. Is he not so?"
十一章, 子曰,李云,李云,玉帛云乎哉? 月云,月云,钟鼓云乎哉?
Chapter 11. The master said, "It is according to the rules of propriety, they say, are gems and silk all that is meant by propriety? It is music, they say, are bells and drums all that is meant by music?" 12章 子曰, 色厉而内人, 辟诸小人, 岂有川鱼之道也与? Chapter 12. The Master said, He who puts on an appearance of stern firmness, while inwardly he is weak, is like one of the small, mean people. Yeah, is he not like the thief who breaks through or climbs over a wall?
13章 子曰, 相怨, 德之贼也。
Chapter 13. The Master said, Your good, careful people of the villages are the thieves of virtue.
14章 子曰, 道听而徒说, 德之器也。
Chapter 14. The Master said, To tell as we go along what we have heard on the way is to cast away our virtue.
15章 子曰, 彼夫可于事君也于哉? 其为得之也, 患得之, 己得之, 患失之, 苟患失之, 无所不至矣。
Chapter 15. The Master said, There are those mean creatures. How impossible it is along with them to serve one's prince. While they have not got their aims, their anxiety is how to get them. When they have got them, their anxiety is lest they should lose them. When they are anxious lest such things should be lost, there is nothing to which they will not proceed.
16章 子曰, 古者, 民有三急, 今也或是之无也, 古之狂也似, 今之狂也当, 古之今也廉, 今之今也愤佞, 古之愚也直, 今之愚也诈而已矣。
Chapter 16. The Master said, Anciently, men had three failings, which now, perhaps, are not to be found. The high-mindedness of antiquity showed itself in a disregard of small things. The high-mindedness of the present day shows itself in wild license. The stern dignity of antiquity showed itself in grave reserve. The stern dignity of the present day shows itself in quarrelsome perverseness. The stupidity of antiquity showed itself in straightforwardness. The stupidity of the present day shows itself in sheer deceit.
17章 子曰, 巧言令色显宜人。
Chapter 17. The Master said, Fine words and an insinuating appearance are seldom associated with virtue.
18章 子曰, 吾子之夺诸也,吾正身之乱雅乐也,吾利口之富邦家者.
Chapter 18. The Master said, I hate the manner in which purple takes away the luster of vermilion. I hate the way in which the songs of Zhen confound the music of the Ya. I hate those who, with their sharp mouths, overthrow kingdoms and families.
19章 子曰, 鱼欲无言。 子贡曰, 子如不言, 则小子何述言? 子曰, 天何言哉? 四时行焉, 百物生焉, 天何言哉?
Chapter 19. The Master said, I would prefer not speaking.
子贡 said, If you, Master, do not speak, what shall we, your disciples, have to record?
The Master said, Does heaven speak? The four seasons pursue their courses, and all things are continually being produced. But does heaven say anything?
20章 如碑遇见孔子, 孔子辞以其, 将命者出户, 取色而歌, 使之闻之.
Chapter 20. Rubei wished to see Confucius, but Confucius declined, on the ground of being sick, to see him. When the bearer of this message went out at the door, the Master took his lute and sent to it, in order that Bei might hear him.
21章 才我问, 三年之丧期已久矣? 君子三年不为礼, 礼必坏, 三年不为乐, 乐必崩, 旧古既末, 新古既生, 钻髓改火, 期可以矣?
子曰, 是夫道, 依夫谨, 于如安乎? 曰,安。 如安则为之, 夫君子之居丧, 四之不甘，闻乐不乐，居处不安，故不为也。今汝安则为之。宰我出，子曰：“予之不仁也，子生三年，然后免于父母之怀。夫三年之丧，天下之通丧也。予也有三年之爱于其父母乎？” Chapter 21. Zaiwo asked about the 3 years mourning for parents, saying that 1 year was long enough. If the superior man, said he, abstains for 3 years from the observances of propriety, those observances will be quite lost. If for 3 years he abstains from music, music will be ruined. Within a year the old grain is exhausted, and the new grain has sprung up, and in procuring fire by friction, we go through all the changes of wood for that purpose. After complete year, the mourning may stop. The master said, If you were, after year, to eat good rice and wear embroidered clothes, would you feel at ease?
I should, replied Wu.
The master said, If you can feel at ease, do it. But a superior man, during the whole period of mourning, does not enjoy pleasant food which he may eat, nor derive pleasure from music which he may hear. He also does not feel at ease if he is comfortably lodged. Therefore he does not do what you propose. But now you feel at ease and may do it. Tsai Wo then went out, and the master said, This shows Yu's want of virtue. It is not till a child is 3 years old that it is allowed to leave the arms of its parents. And the 3 years' mourning is universally observed throughout the empire. Did you enjoy the 3 years' love of his parents?
22.子曰：“饱食终日无所用心，难逆哉！不有博弈者乎？为之由贤乎矣。”
Chapter 22. The master said, Hard is it to deal with him who will stuff himself with food the whole day, without applying his mind to anything good. Are there not gamesters and chess players? To be one of these would still be better than doing nothing at all.
23章。子路曰：“君子尚勇乎？”子曰：“君子义以为上，君子有勇而无义为乱，小人有勇而无义为道。”
Chapter 23. Zilu said, Does the superior man esteem valor? The master said, The superior man holds righteousness to be of highest importance. A man in a superior situation, having valor without righteousness, will be guilty of insubordination. One of the lower people, having valor without righteousness, will commit robbery.
24章。子贡曰：“君子亦有物乎？” 子曰：“有物，吾称人之恶者，吾居下流而善上者，吾勇而无礼者，吾果敢而智者。”曰：“次也亦有物乎？吾矫以为智者，吾不逊以为勇者，吾竭以为直者。”
Chapter 24. 子贡 said, Has the superior man his hatreds also? The master said, He has his hatreds. He hates those who proclaim the evil of others. He hates the man who, being in a low station, slanders his superiors. He hates those who have valor merely and are unobservant of propriety. He hates those who are forward and determined and, at the same time, of contracted understanding. The master then inquired, Ci, have you also your hatreds? Zigong replied, I hate those who pry out matters and ascribe the knowledge to their wisdom. I hate those who are only not modest and think that they are valorous. I hate those who make known secrets and think that they are straightforward.
25章。子曰：“唯女子与小人为难养也，近之则不逊，远之则怨。”
Chapter 25. The master said, Of all people, girls and servants are the most difficult to behave to. If you are familiar with them, they lose their humility. If you maintain a reserve towards them, they are discontented. 子曰：年四十而见恶焉，其中也矣。 Chapter 26. The Master said, when a man at 40 is the object of dislike, he will always continue what he is. End of Book 17. Recording by Li Jing.